Now in our callback, we drill down to get the get user data function. This will actually give us a pointer to the entity that created these physics bodies that are touching. Now from here, we start down a new magical rabbit hole. For each of the objects that are touching, we need to signal that a collision has occurred to it. We do this by calling a new function called onTouch and passing it in the other physics body that it's touching. So you can see that entity A gets an onTouch function called, passing in the body B, and entity B gets an onTouch function called, passing in body A. This setup allows each individual entity to respond to collisions in their own way. So for instance, the onTouch event for a missile would remove 5 health from the player it's colliding with, or if it's just hitting a wall, it may just decide to self-destruct. But we haven't written this onTouch function yet. And in order to do that, we need to hop all the way back to entity.js and add an onTouch function that allows other units to overload this function with custom logic later. It's probably worth pointing out that you should be doing a whole series of data checking to ensure that the information given to the postSelf function is valid. So for example, whether or not body A and body B are valid objects or simply null, and whether or not they point to proper entity types and have onTouch functions. Now, we'll let you grovel through all of these issues in the future, but we figured that we'd let you get a glimpse at the madness behind the mask. So that means that anyone who defines a physics body should also define an onTouch function.